Very good morning to all the students of class plus 2C. Yes, beta, as you can see, I have written already all the points on the board. And while you all were joining, we have done quick revision also. So those who are joining now, it's your fault. By the time students were joining, we were doing revision side by side of all the pages done. Clear? So join well in time always. So the quote written here on the board is, work hard in silence, let success do the talking. It means rather than you speak up about or you boast about your achievements or your efforts, you keep on doing efforts silently, the output will definitely tell the people that what you have done, okay? Your success will show it. So the way Gandhiji and Rajkumar Shukla kept on doing their efforts silently, and rest is history, whatever you have seen, how we... you can say how they attained success in this movement. So very important concept, beta. You can say you get questions for 6 marks, long questions, short questions, or you can get objective based questions also in this. Fine. So let's discuss without wasting time. We are going to read from page 50 onwards today. Till 49 we have already read, and I have discussed with all the points with you all. Now, Gandhiji disobeyed the legal notice and signed a receipt. Now, I told you that when Gandhiji was intruding, intrusion is called interference. When Gandhiji took the, you can say, responsibility, I must say, of helping the Indian peasants in Champaran district, led by Rajkumar Shukla. So, you know, Britishers started feeling that uneasiness. They knew that there was not a single person who was helping these illiterate farmers and peasants. But now there comes a man who looks very simple, you know, simple living and high thinking, but he has the knowledge because he has done law. Now they were, you know, getting aware. So they gave a legal notice to Gandhiji when he started helping the Indian peasants to greater extent. So after getting legal notice, Abhirup and Amitos, you just joined for the sake of attendance. And in between, if you will be leaving, beta, you are not going to be marked present today. And I can ask you the questions in between. Say, then Gandhiji disobeyed the legal notice and signed a receipt. Rather than accepting, he knew the legal way out. Fine, there was a provision of, he disobeyed, he signed a receipt and he said, I won't be leaving this Champaran district. So what was the legal notice? Legal notice was about quit Champaran. Fine, when they saw this man is going to another level, so then they asked him to leave. But rather than leaving, he signed a receipt. He said, I disobey your orders. So after that, what was the aftermath? What happened next? After signing a receipt, obviously, he was summoned by police. And this is what Gandhiji wanted, that he wanted to be called by authorities and Britishers and British landlords so that he can have a good talk with them. So Motihari black with the peasants. What does it mean? This is another question, with a textual question in your book. So Motihari is the name of the district again, adjoining Champaran. So many people from Champaran, from Motihari and from adjoining district, they started, you know, getting together. Now they were getting, unity could be seen easily, you can say. So many peasants, thousands of peasants, they started walking on foot and they started joining Gandhiji. Many influential people like Rajendra Prasad and other leaders, they started helping Gandhiji in this movement. And they started making plans and how they will help Gandhiji. Gandhiji said that, you know, those days in Hindi, it is called Jail Bharo Andolan. You might have heard this term in SST. So what does it mean? That they have to go to jail, and maximum people, as many people they could go, they were also accompanying Gandhiji, that we are ready to go to jail with you. Even many lawyers came. Fine. Many lawyers who were educated, many uneducated, illiterate peasants, many people of influential background, everyone joined Gandhiji that, yes, we are ready to go to jail with you. And let's see for how long these people can keep us inside. And then they have to take a decision. So they were, meanwhile, they were planning. Motihari was, you can say, filled with many peasants, then government was baffled. What do you mean by the word baffled? Anyone can tell me? Yes, anyone is there who knows the meaning of baffled? Don't waste your time, but immediately tell me. Raise your hand. Baffled means? No one knows, see. So baffled means confused. Government was now confused what to do. Fine? And they were thinking that now this agitation is going to higher level. The single person, Rajkumar Shukla, then Gandhiji, and now many influential people, pressure was there on the government. Fine? So they got baffled. Then this is with a mark, it very important. Civil disobedience had triumphed. Triumph means won over. So finally, for the first time, civil disobedience won. I would be showing you one news extract today that how it happened. Fine. And then Gandhiji had 4 interviews with lieutenants. After this, for the first time in history of India, what is civil disobedience? When political leaders or any person of influential background or anyone politely, without showing aggression or without showing any, you can say harsh, using harsh words, in a very good manner, somebody disobeys the law system, that is called civil disobedience. And it had never happened in the history of India that somebody who disobeyed the orders of a civil system, he could win in the past. But for the first time, Gandhiji disobeyed the law that he won't be leaving Champaran, and he won in this because government was pressurized. It arranged interviews of Gandhiji with influential higher authorities, lieutenants, journals and all. Then finally, Gandhiji, after having interviewed, Gandhiji asked for 50% repayment. Why didn't he ask for 100% repayment? The reason I would be discussing with you all. Firstly, you people tell me, is it clear? All the points clear to you? Send me thumbs up quickly. I want to see those who are listening. Yes, Sukman Jod. Yes, Saksham. Yes, Anushka, Apoorv, Suhani, Rana Gurjeet, Fateh Singh, Lakshit. And why I'm naming you, Kakshi is there, fine. So I'm just checking whether Amarpreet is there, fine. Many others, I'm not naming everyone. I don't want to waste the time now. Jagraj, fine. Well done to all those who are sending thumbs up. At least you are listening, fine. So now after this beta, let's continue because this chapter is quite lengthy. A small clipping I would be showing you, and then we will be going back. Just see. This is
100 years ago, on the 10th of April 1917, Mahatma Gandhi arrived in Muzaffarpur. He was on his way to Champaran, where an anxious population was waiting for him.
So, beta, I'm showing you after 100 years of that movement, this coverage was done by Rajya Sabha, you can say RSTV, one of the news channels. And they have shown how people were eagerly waiting outside the law court, and how Gandhiji went inside, and how thousands of peasants were together. This is the real footage you are getting to see. And how that happened actually. 12th April 1917, Mahatma Gandhi arrived in Muzaffarpur. So I'll be showing you. Just see.
They included distressed farmers, people who were burdened by taxes. Champaran was in dire need of a messina who would answer their concern. Gandhi, on the other hand, had come with a clear notion about satyagraha. All he needed was an opportunity to try it. Champaran provided him just that. And that's how it became the perfect base of his satyagraha. When Gandhi reached Champaran, he was shocked to see filled all over him. Streets filled with dirt, adding to the general lack of hygiene.
So I showed you the condition of the people, the plight of the people in Champaran was so poor. They were into farming only. There were no other occupations. They were not aware. They didn't know how to sign. They were using their thumb for impressions. They were not aware citizens. Fine, so many problems were there. Gandhiji never thought that he would be coming with this Rajkumar Shukla and he would be spending consecutive 7 months of his life over there. Fine, and after that, many short visits also. So came for a day, and you imagine that 7 months he devoted in this movement and how it created history. Fine. So I would be sharing the screen of the chapter now, beta. In between, I'll be showing you the videos also. Fine. So we have read so far that Gandhiji did not leave when he was asked to. You can say leave. He proceeded to Motihari, the capital of Champaran. So where is you can say Motihari is the capital of Champaran. Underline this. I would be increasing my beta speed. Is it okay for you all? Because it's very lengthy chapter. He went to a house and using it as headquarters, continued his investigations. A report came in that a peasant had been maltreated in a nearby village. Gandhi decided to go and see. The next morning, he started out on the back of an elephant. So in between, when Gandhiji was doing efforts to, you know, this for this indigo crop, Gandhiji got a news that one of the peasants was treated maltreated. So Gandhiji just went to see that peasant. He had not proceeded far when the police superintendent's messenger overtook him and ordered him to return to town. So when he started on the way, he was stopped by British officials that you cannot go further. Gandhi complied. He said that he served him with an official notice to quit Champaran immediately. He says, I have a legal notice for you, Mr. Gandhi, that you have to leave Champaran immediately. Gandhi, rather than, you know, politely, in a very nice way, patient manner, he signed a receipt for the notice and wrote on it that he would disobey the order because he knew the legal way of disobedient, fine, of being disobedient. So he signed a receipt. What happened in consequence? Gandhi received a summon to appear in the court. Summon is a call. Fine, he was called in the court next day, which is what he wanted. All night, Gandhi remained awake. He telegraphed Rajendra Prasad to come from Bihar with influential friends. He sent instructions to the ashram. He wired a full report to the viceroy. Morning found the town of Motihari black with peasants. I discussed with you. This is the time he could not sleep for the whole night. He kept on finding the ways. What will he do? He called his influential friends. Next morning, thousands of peasants got, you can say they came over there. They did not know Gandhi's record in South Africa. They had merely heard that a Mahatma who wanted to help them was in trouble. So when they realized that a man who has no relation with us, he is helping us, why should not we go to help him? He's working for us only. Now the awareness started. This is what Gandhi wanted. He wanted to create awareness. The officials felt powerless. I told you government was baffled now. He helped them regulate the crowd. So Gandhi helped the government to regulate the crowd. Government was not able to control the crowd even. He was polite and friendly. He was giving them concrete proof that their might, hitherto dreaded and unquestioned, could be challenged by Indians. Fine. So he was giving assurance to people, fine, that up to this time yet. So hitherto here means beta up to this time. So he's saying that ab tak hitherto, that nobody is able to, you can say, shake them. So definitely he was assuring them that you can do everything, but by showing patience only. So he controlled the crowd. Government was baffled. The prosecutor requested the judge to postpone the trial. You see, when Gandhiji was inside the courts, thousands of peasants gathered together, as you have seen in the video. Apparently, the authorities wished to consult their superior. So what they did, they postponed the trial with Gandhiji. Gandhiji was called by authorities. So they thought, if we take the decision now, anything can happen outside. Thousands of people, even our authorities are lesser in number that day. So they decided to postpone the decision or that trial. Gandhi protested against the delay. Gandhi said, now tell me why you are delaying the protest. You called me. I signed the receipt of disobeying the law. You called me and now you're not giving any decision. Give me one, you can say, decision. He read a statement pleading guilty. He was involved. He told the court in a conflict of duties on the one hand, not to set a bad example as a lawbreaker, on the other hand, to render the humanitarian and national service for which he had come, he disregarded the order to leave. Not for want of respect, underline beta, for lawful authority, but in obedience to the higher law of our being, the voice of conscience, he asked the penalty due. So he was asked by the authorities that why did he sign that receipt? Why didn't he leave the place when he was given legal notice? He gave an answer that he was in conflict of duties. What is the meaning of conflict of duties? On one hand, he doesn't want to break the law, being a lawyer himself, fine, being a true citizen to his own country. On the other hand, his conscience did not allow him to leave these innocent peasants. He said, he asked the penalty, you said, whatever you say, I'm ready to take the punishment. You just take a decision. I'm here for you, Gandhiji said. The magistrate announced that he would pronounce sentence after a 2-hour recess and asked Gandhi to furnish bail for those 120 minutes. So you see, magistrate was not able to take any decision. He thought if he takes decision in, you can say, favor of Gandhi, he will be asked by authorities. If he take against Gandhi, then many people are standing outside, anything can happen. So rather than he took 120 minutes out of it, he announced a 2-hour recess. Gandhi refused. Gandhi said, why you are giving bail to me now? I have not asked for bail. You give me a decision, whatever your decision is. Gandhi knew that this is the time when to hit, you know, when things are burning, then hit at that time. The judge released him without bail. So there was no option out. He was released from the clutches of British authorities. When the court reconvened, the judge said he would not deliver the judgment for several days. See, those 2-hour recess that led to several days now. Meanwhile, he allowed Gandhi to remain at liberty, and they could not keep Gandhiji at, you can say, jail, because that can lead to trouble for themselves only. So now page number 51. Rajendra Prasad, Brij Kishore Babu, underline, Maulana Mazharul Haq, and several other prominent lawyers. They all were educated lawyers. They arrived from Bihar. In the meantime, unko time mil gaya. They conferred with Gandhiji. What would they do if he was sentenced to prison? Gandhi asked. Why, the senior lawyer replied, they had come to advise and help him. If he went to jail, there would be nobody to advise and they would go home. What about the injustice to the sharecroppers? Gandhi demanded. So Gandhi started asking if after a few days they will be taking a decision. If they send me to jail because of this disobeying the law, what you people would do? One of the lawyers said they would go back home because there is no leader. What will they do? Gandhiji said, what about the injustice to the sharecroppers? Lawyers of my country are talking like this. Then lawyers withdrew to consult. Rajendra Prasad has recorded the upshot of their consultation. They thought amongst themselves that Gandhi was totally a stranger, and yet he was prepared to go to prison for the sake of the peasants. If they, on the other hand, being not only residents of the adjoining districts, but also those who claim to have served these peasants, should go home, it would be shameful desertion. Rajendra Prasad said, if Gandhi, he has nothing to do with these peasants, even then he is ready to go to jail for these peasants. This is a desertion. This is cheating. Desertion means chhod dena. If we will desert these peasants, it is a shameful thing. So if Gandhi is ready to go to jail, we should also be ready to go to jail with him. I told you about jail bharo andolan already. Fine. So they accordingly went back to Gandhi and told him that they are ready to follow him into jail. The battle of Champaran is won. Underline beta. Here they are not, it's not now, the fight is not only about Indigo Crow. The fight has gone to another level now. Gandhi wanted to create awareness among people, among peasants, among all the influential personalities, and they were aware now. So battle of Champaran is won. Wo jeet chuke hain kyunki they are aware now. He exclaimed, these are the words of Gandhiji, that this is what he wanted. Then he took a piece of paper and divided the group into pairs and put down the order in which each pair was to court arrest. Now, you know, there is a hierarchy or a priority. The people who are having sound knowledge, fine, they are having lesser knowledge, they are having no knowledge. So Gandhi made a plan. He divided the people in groups. fine, that when they will be going to jail, if Gandhi goes, in case Gandhi goes, who will be following him next and who will be helping the peasants out. Several days later, Gandhi received a written communication from the magistrate informing him that Lieutenant Governor of the province had ordered the case to be dropped. Civil disobedience had triumphed the first time in modern India. Underline and mark it with a star. For the first time in history, what happened? Gandhi got a written communication from magistrate of the court directly. Or kya likha tha us written communication mein? That Lieutenant Governor of the province had ordered that case to be dropped. That dropped this case. That hum apna case wapis lete hain. We are going to drop. This had happened for the first time. So this is the winning movement for Gandhi ji. Gandhi and the lawyers now proceeded to conduct a far-flung inquiry into the grievances of the farmers. So Gandhi ji now channelized his time into another thing. He thought, I would be meeting farmers. I would be asking the written communication from all the peasants that what they want. Depositions by about 10,000 peasants were written down. Can you imagine? Ek Rajkumar Shukla, abhi yahan pe hazaron. Thousands of peasants came and they wrote down and documents were collected. Whole area throbbed with the activity. Achha, aap mein se kisne dekhi hai that movie? Have you seen, beta, that movie Nayak? Send me thumbs up. I'm going to relate the Nayak movie with this. Rana Gurjit is the first one to. Yes, Amarpreet has. If you have not seen, watch that movie, please, on my request. Nayak movie, which is, you can say, one of the leading actors, Anil Kapoor is there. And one day, PM he became, or CM he became, I don't remember exactly. He became one day chair for, one day he got the chair and maybe prime minister he became. And the way he worked, absolutely beautiful movie it is, though it is practically not possible, but when you watch, it's a, you can say, it's a, you can say, very good to watch. Fine. And you will be getting knowledge how he helped poor people in one day when he became PM. Fine. So the same way Gandhiji was having less number of days with him, but even then he was working on this. Clear? And he started getting thousands of written documents produced. Then he got written evidences, whole area throbbed. In June, Gandhi was summoned to Sir Edward Gate. The Lieutenant Governor ne unko bulaya. He called him directly. Before he went, he met leading associates and again laid detailed plans for civil disobedience. Gandhiji was making many plans that if in case he was be asked to disobey, what he should do. Gandhi had 4 interviews with Lieutenant Governor as a result. An inquiry was made into indigo sharecropper. The commissioner consisted of, underline this beta, landlords, government officials, Gandhiji. As the sole representative, only representative of peasants was Gandhiji. Koi aur peasant nahi jayega, only Gandhiji. Gandhi remained in Champaran for initial uninterrupted period of 7 months. But you have a test tomorrow. Fine. Based on this chapter, it is compulsory. Very easy test. It is objective based on Google form. We will be sending the link exactly at 5 p.m. tomorrow. So don't give any reason that we have patients and all. You have to appear for the test. I can check your knowledge accordingly then. Okay. So the visit undertaken casually on the entreaty of an unlettered peasant, in the expectation that it would last a few days, occupied almost a year of Gandhi's life. Gandhi ji ne nahi socha tha. He never have even imagined that he will be going there for a few days, but he almost a year, but exactly uninterrupted 7 months. And then after that shorter visits, he stayed there in Champaran. The official inquiry assembled a crushing mountain of evidence against the big planters. He was now having a huge mountain of signed documents with him, which he could show to British landlords and to make refunds to the peasants. But how much must we pay? They asked Gandhi. Gandhi se pucha gaya ye question that how much you want back? How much repayment of funds you want? They thought he would demand repayment in full of the money which they had illegal and deceitfully extorted from the sharecroppers. This is illegally they have taken from Indian peasants. But Gandhi asked only 50%. There he seemed adamant writes Reverend J.H. Hodge, a British missionary in Champaran who observed the entire episode at Claws Ridge. Thinking probably that he would not give way, representative of planters offered to refund the extent of 25%. And to amazement, Gandhi took him at his word, thus breaking the deadlock. Now I am going to end the meet with very important point, beta. This is the turning point. When Gandhiji waited for months to have word with British officials, higher authorities, lieutenants, magistrate, when he had interviews, he should have asked for 100% repayment, but he did not ask. He asked for 50% repayment of funds to the sharecroppers. Why? Can anybody answer? And you know, in return, they agreed to 25%. They said, we will not give 100% repayment, not even 50%. We will repay 25% settlement. And to break the deadlock, Gandhiji agreed to 25% settlement. Now peasants are worried, those who are waiting outside, why Gandhiji agreed to 25%. This is the question which you need to answer. Rana Gurjeet, can you answer, beta? Gandhiji at 25% agreed. What do you think? Anything?
No idea.
Yes, beta, why he agreed to 25%?
No idea.
No idea. Any other? Amarpreet? Rana Gurjeet says he has no idea. Whatever you feel like, Amarpreet. Why did Gandhi agree to 25%? Kanubha? Okay, bell has gone. So I am leaving this question with you, ma'am. Something is better than nothing. Very good. Saksham Sharma has written, something is better than nothing. This is answer. This answer is not bad, but I will tell you tomorrow. Okay. So we will start our discussion from this question onwards. You will also answer me. Okay, beta. Have a nice day and read this chapter thoroughly. Very important, and all the best for your test. You have test tomorrow.